Oh, ideal therapy pet. I think my ideal therapy pet would probably be a gorilla, because they can write and stuff. And so if I'm sitting on the couch explaining my problems to a pet, like gorillas probably.
My ideal therapy pet would be a full-grown Bengal tiger. You know, you see a lot of people at the airport with therapy animals. And if you have a lethal jungle cat, you can board the plane whenever you want. Makes life a lot easier.
Or a bird, because they can talk to you.
An ideal therapy pet? I would think is it a golden retriever? I mean, they're so pretty and all.
An ideal therapy pet, therapy. It's like when you lean back on a couch and you tell someone all your woes.
Maybe a Newfoundland. I had Newfoundlands back in the day, and they're such lovely animals and quite smart. So I would say a big old Newfoundland to just have around all the time.
A parrot would probably be the best, right? Because then they could pay attention to what you're saying, they could repeat what you're saying, you know, and then they could ask you, how does that make you feel? And their hands are so articulate, they could probably play tic-tac-toe when you think they're writing something down.
Once again, I think you go back to dogs, you know. They're just incredible. Certainly Labrador, certain retriever breeds and stuff are really, I mean, they just sense people. They can sense all kinds of things about people, and they can be really mellow and really loving.
Ooh, I think my ideal therapy pet would be a mini goat. A pair of them.
Why?
Because mini goats are absolutely one of the cutest things in the entire world. They scream like humans. Ah! They are little rodeos, and you would never not be laughing. I would be laughing the entire time if I had mini goats as therapy pets.
What's my ideal therapy pet? Of course it's Edie. We chill on the couch every night, watch some Animal Planet, and she levels me out.